In one of the lab assignments, you're being asked to determine whether there are too many people to fit in a room or whether there's still some room for some more people. This video covers a program very, very similar. It has the exact same logic. So all you have to do is change a few of the words to make it work for the lab assignment that you've been given. For several professional sports programs, such as the NFL football, you can have 53 people on the active roster. For NBA basketball, you can only have 13. For Major League Baseball, you get 25. And for hockey, up to 23. So here is the description for a sample lab report. It says, different sports allow a different number of active players that are allowed on each team. For example, the NFL allows 53. The NBA allows 13. Baseball allows 25, and NHL hockey allows 23. Design a C or C++ program that does the following. Determine whether a team has too few, too many, or just enough players. The program will ask for and read the number of players allowed on the team and ask for and read the number of players that are trying to get on the team. If the number of players trying to get on the team are less than the number permitted on the team, the program will display there are not enough players. NN, more players are needed, where NN is the number of players needed. If the number of players trying to get on the team is greater than the number of players permitted, the program will display there are too many players. NN players need to be eliminated, where NN is the number of players to be eliminated. If the number of players trying to get on the team is equal to the number of players permitted, the program will display you have enough players. If you haven't noticed, sometimes one of the biggest problems with word problems is there's just too much information. So let's try to get rid of some of the superfluous stuff and find out what's really important and use only the stuff that we need for the program. Let's start off with the input and output information. Since this program is asking us to determine whether a team has too few or just enough, well, it doesn't say, it really doesn't have anything to do with the type of sport. So let's get rid of all the stuff that has for NFL, NBA, Major League Baseball, and hockey. Let's get rid of all of that stuff. Let's find the inputs. There's a sentence here that says the program will ask for and read the number of players allowed. Oh, that's an input. And the program has to ask for and read the number of players that are trying to get on the team. So we only have two pieces of input data. Now let's find the outputs. The outputs, there are three different outputs in this program. Either there's not enough players, there's too many players, or you have enough. Now if there's not enough or too many, we also need to identify how many we need or how many need to be eliminated. This program lends itself very well to using the if, else if, else statements. The first if is going to test to see if there are too few players. And we can do that by if we know how many players are maximum for the team. And if the number of players trying to get on the team is less than the maximum, well, then there's not enough players. Okay, so then we have the if. Then there's the if else. Well, if there are more players trying to get on the team than there's room, then we have an if-else. And then we have the else all the way at the end that will pick up anything that's left over. In our case, it's just enough players. Now we can develop the hypochart, input, processing, output. Our inputs are the number of players permitted, and I call it players on team, so that's our maximum. The outputs, not enough, and how many extra needed, or too many, and how many to eliminate, or you have enough players. So the outputs are going to be determined by the if, else if, else. In the processing section, let's read the players permitted from the keyboard, read the number of players on the team, and here we go. If players on team is less than players permitted, display there are not enough players, compute the additional players that we can have, and display the additional players and say are needed. Here's the else if. Else if players on team is greater than the players permitted, display there are too many players. then we'll compute the number of players to be eliminated and display that number and say to be eliminated. Here comes the else, our default condition. So if it isn't that we don't have enough and it isn't that we have too many, then what's left over is we have enough. So we'll just display you have enough players. Let's figure out how to enter the program. At the top, we'll have the title block, which is a bunch of comments. We need the program name, the date and version, and your name. Then we need the include files. There's that weird Microsoft thing, include, quote, stdafx.h, quote, and we only need that for Microsoft Visual C++, but everybody is going to need pound include iostream. Then we'll also need using namespace standard, semicolon. Then we'll have the int main, int argc and character star argv, open and close square brackets. And then our open curly brace begins the block of code. First thing, we have our variables. I know I need two variables for our inputs, one for the number of players permitted, and also for the players on the team. I also need to compute two things in case I have either not enough players or too many players. So I have two more variables. I put in players needed and extra players. We need to input the data. So I've used a cout and a cin for each piece of input data. The cout is the prompt. It's putting a message on the screen telling the user they need to type something in. So on my prompt, I have cout less than, open parentheses. How many players are permitted? A space, a close quote, and then a semicolon. And then I can use the cn to read players permitted. I'll do the same thing for how many players want to be on the team. And then I'll put in input, use cn to input players on team. Here comes the compound if, else if, else. I call it compound because I have more than one statement hooked up to the if. I have more than one statement hooked up to the if else. And although I only have one statement hooked up to the last else, I still put it in curly braces just so it looks nice. So I use the curly braces to identify a block of code that's hooking up to the if. There's another set of curly braces identifying the block of code that hooks up to the else if. And then there's the last set of curly braces for the else. On the if statement, it says, if, open parenthesis, players on team is less than players permitted, close parenthesis, open curly brace. And then I'm using the cout to say there are not enough players. ENDL moves our cursor down to the next line, and then I'll compute the number of players needed. That's the number of players permitted minus the players on the team. Then on the next line, I'll use cout to say, where it says players needed, that's going to be displaying the number that was computed in the line ahead of us. Then less than, so I can do some more stuff on the same line, and then it will say space, players are needed. I put a space right in front of the word players because otherwise I'll have the number and it will be right up against the letter P for players. The else if is pretty similar. It says else if players on team is greater than players permitted. Then I'll say cout less than, quote, there are too many players, quote, less than, ENDL, and the ENDL moves us down to the next line. Now I need to compute how many extra players there are. So I'll say extra players equals players on team minus players permitted. Then display it with cout less than. Extra players right here, notice there's no quotes around it, so it's going to display the number that was just computed on the previous line. Less than, so I can add more stuff on the output. And then I'll say, quote, players needed to be eliminated, quote. Notice again I used a space right in front of the word players so that the number that was displayed won't run right up next to the letter P. then ENDL moves the cursor down to the next line. Here's the else. The else says whatever's left over. So I already tested for less than, and I tested for greater than, and the only thing that's left over is I have the right number of players. So then I can say cout less than, quote, you have enough players, quote, less than, ENDL. Then there's the return zero, and my program is done. The last thing I need to do is to test it out and test all three conditions. So I tested it with 53 are permitted. I only have 60. Whoa, it was too few players. I still need 7 people. Tested again with 2 inputs. It says how many players are permitted, 27. How many players want to be on the team, 21. Oh, there's not enough players. I still need 6 more. 6 players are needed. Okay, test it one more time. How many players are permitted? 13. How many players want to be on the team? 13. You have enough players. So I've tested all three conditions. So if you have all of this logic and you're trying to figure out how many people can fit in a room, if there's too many, or if there's still room for some more, well, all you have to do is change a few of the words for this program and you have that assignment done. The end.